isosceles triangle means that two sides are equal. So what you want to do, and I would do it, I would just draw a diagram where two sides are the same. A scalene triangle, none of them are the same. So put 3, 4, 5. The distance formula, I would do this all the time because this is what helps me minimize my problems or my mistakes. Okay, so at this point, I would put my x's, and it doesn't matter which one you put first. I'm going to go with that one. So -4, -8, and then -7, and then +4. Now, if you didn't do it this way, don't sweat it. We should get the same answer. If you did it the other way, instead of a +4, you got a negative. It's not going to matter. Instead of a -11, you got a positive. Again, it's not going to matter, because when you square it, it becomes 16 plus whatever that is. And so your final answer looks like 137. But if you put 137, it's going to be wrong, okay, because that's not correct. It's the square root. Thank you. All right, any questions on the bell work? All right, today we're going on to this next section, which is 5.2. So on a new sheet of paper. Copy down these three and put 5.2. Explain, and we'll go one by one, so don't feel like you got to write them all down. So look up here. The triangle sum theorem is very important, and what that says is that every triangle adds up to 180. So write that down. Every triangle adds up to 180. If you want to write down the word every, go ahead. That's up to you. So every triangle adds up to 180. So if we have a triangle on the ELC and they tell you this one is 30 and this one is 40 and this one is X, well, from what I just told you, those angles add up to 180. So all you do, it's real simple. All you do is take 180 and you subtract 40, and then you subtract 30, and you get 110. So your answer here, even though the diagram is wrong, because 110 degrees is actually very big, but don't worry about the diagram, because usually they qualify it, and they say not drawn to scale, is what they usually say. All right, so the triangle sum theorem is what I just gave you. Okay, next. So the next one is the exterior angle theorem. So look right here. Draw this diagram right there. And then label this W, X, Y, and Z. All right, a lot of kids don't use this one, but I got to show it to you anyway, because Carnegie will ask you specifically. All right, so they want to know, well, what is the exterior angle? So put exterior angle is angle. Now watch what I do. This one right here is the exterior angle. I want you to name that angle. Remember, it takes 3 points, according to Carnegie, okay, to name an angle. And you should be able to name that. So go ahead and name that angle for me, please. If you can't do it, then you really need to get on the ball here, because this is stuff you should know. Does anybody know what it would be, that exterior angle? Nobody has a clue how to name that? Say it again. You could say WXY. What's another way I could say it? YXW. But I'll go with that one. Very good. WXY. Excellent. This one right here is called a remote interior angle, and so is this one. So write that down, remote interior angles. And there's two of them. I want you to name both of those, R1 and R2. Name those two remote interior angles. What are they? Okay, name those two angles. All right, some of you got that right. So how would I name R1? Anybody? You could say angle Y, but what's another way to do it? X, well, you don't want to say XZY, because that would be that one. We do want that one. But this one would be what? XYZ. So angle XYZ for that one. And then the bottom one will go with what you said. So XZY. If you're doing your Carnegie, you know that this is what they're trying to teach you, okay? Because these are questions they're going to ask you. All right, any questions on the remote interior or the exterior? A lot of kids say this one right here, but that's not true. These are supplementary or a linear pair, but they're not remote. Okay. What is a theorem? Remember, there's something called a postulate and a theorem. Does anybody know what a theorem is? This is just a review. Anybody at all? A theorem is something you can prove. Like someone says, prove it. Like an attorney. An attorney better be able to prove what he's saying, or don't say it. Okay, because they're taught to know the answer before they ask the question. That's the way they're taught. If they don't know the answer, they don't ask the question. It's just part of going through law school. Okay? A postulate, on the other hand, is something you accept without proof. Like, who's your daddy? Okay? You just accept that. I mean, it's true, unless you get a DNA test. Right? I mean, you've heard it before, right? Mama's baby, daddy's maybe? Think about that. All right, draw that triangle, please. Draw this triangle right there, please. All right, well, you were just taught that every triangle adds up to how much? By what theorem? Triangle sum theorem. And what does theorem mean? You can prove it. You can prove it.
So no matter what.
So, yeah, no matter what. So this one I think we already did. This is 70, and the whole thing is worth 180. So 180 minus 70 is going to give you your answer of 110. And even though the diagram is wrong, it's what you're going to go with. All right, now this one's a little different. So draw that diagram and write down those directions. Name the shortest to longest side. The shortest to longest side. Draw that diagram. Now here's the way I would do it. Well, first, I would find this one. And we already did it. So put 110 up here. We already did that one by the triangle sum theorem. Now, take a look right here and think about it, okay? Like, I think I told you, right? When I was a kid, I mean, we literally had alligators if we wanted them, because you could go to the pet shop and buy a baby alligator. Okay? So when you go in the backyard, it wasn't that they were happy to see you, because they're wild animals. So they would raise their mouth like this, shh, and hiss at you. And as you got closer, you became more of a threat. And instead of this, shh, they would go, shh. They're really ready, okay? And they're small, so they didn't hurt too bad, okay? So what the bottom line is this. If they open up a little bit, the distance from the tip of my finger,
let me make that clear.
If they open up a little bit, the distance from the tip of my finger is small, okay? The distance from here to here is small. But if they open up bigger, then of course that distance is bigger. So the bigger the angle, the bigger the side. That's a rule in geometry. It makes sense. Like if I'm playing pool and I'm trying to bank the ball, I understand that if I come in real steep, it's going to shoot back out short. But if I go in at a wider angle and shoot it, it's going to come out. I mean, if you play sports, you throw a basketball up, you understand that. Okay? It's all about angles. All right, so if you look here, this one right here has a very small opening. It's only 30 degrees, so B would be the shortest. The smaller the angle, the smaller the side. You might want to write that down, but it makes sense, okay? Math has to make sense. The bigger the angle, the bigger the side. So side C, rather, this would be my biggest. And this one's in the middle. I'm going to say it again. The smaller the angle, the smaller the sides. Common sense, all right? But you got to go right across. So it says name it from shortest to biggest. Well, the shortest one is B. So I would put side B. The one in the middle is side A. And the biggest one would be side C. It's real simple, all right? It's going to be in that Carnegie program, and it's going to be on the EOC. So everybody clear on how to distinguish the biggest side and the small side? And it works the other way around. Like what? The converse is true. So draw this triangle, and let's label it 7, 8, and 9. And let's put A, B, C. The converse is true. The bigger the side, the bigger the what? The angle. Okay? Converse means you switch it. Like some of you, I had to switch. Because I didn't know your personalities, but now I kind of do. All right, so look here. So here, 9 is the biggest. Well, across from the 9 is angle B. So angle B is the biggest. Is everybody clear on why angle B is the biggest? It's across from the biggest side. And likewise, angle C would be the smallest. So everybody clear on how to get the biggest side or the biggest angle? It's real simple. I mean, geometry is really pretty simple. All right. Anyway, let's see what else I have to teach you. All right, let's just review. I want you to name the exterior angle and the remote interior angles. See if your memory is any good. Mine's pretty good. We just went over that. Name the exterior angle and name the remote interior angles. Come on, easy to try. All right, so let's see. Well, this one right here would be my exterior. So put angle ABC. That's easy. This would be a remote. So you could say angle C and get away with it. This one right here is a remote. And again, you can get away with it by saying angle D. So everybody clear on the remote interior and remote exterior? Now we're going to actually work a problem. So draw this diagram here. Draw that diagram. This is called the exterior angle theorem. The exterior angle theorem says that the exterior angle is equal to the sum of the two remotes. It's just the way it works out. Okay? If you own a body shop and somebody gets in an accident and you got to straighten the frame up, you got to know what's straight and what's not straight if you do good work. Okay? So if you look here, the exterior angle, let's just write that down. Exterior angle is equal to remote plus remote. That's all it is. Now, there's another way around that, okay? And most kids, they don't do this theorem, but Carnegie specifically makes you do the theorem. So that's why I got to teach it to you. So look here. 130 is equal to my remote plus my other remote, but I don't know what that one is, and I need it. Does anybody know how I can get this other remote right there? Say it again. That's right. Very good. Every line is worth 180 degrees. Excellent. So if this is 180 degrees, then I subtract and I get 40. Excellent. Now work that problem out. You're done. It's real simple. It's just one-step equation. But she's right, and she got it, okay? Every line is worth 180. Just like every triangle, the inside is worth 180 by the triangle sum theorem. It's really not hard stuff. So I subtract 40, and I get 90. So this angle is 90 degrees. So that's a right triangle is what it is. And that's by using the exterior angle theorem. All right, now it's your turn. Try that one. Now, I kind of changed it up a little bit because the book gives you stupid numbers, like 132 rather than 130. I mean, we're trying to teach concepts. We're not worried about numbers because you got to calculate them. So I don't know why the book uses stupid numbers. You should be able to just figure it out in your head. So draw that diagram and write your equation and then try and find x. Now, I may not be here next week, but it doesn't mean you're not going to work. And please don't get your name on my substitutes list, because the last person that did, he had to apologize to her. And then make his parents know about it.
Jackson.
I can't say.
Yeah. Yeah, it was.
But he did, man, so that was pretty cool. And she accepted it. All right, so the exterior angle is equal to my remote plus my other remote. So write that down, because that's all it is. The exterior angle is equal to the remote plus remote. Now I got to work it. What's three words that you should do first to work this thing? Your teacher always tries to drill you with that. Three words. Say it again. Excellent. Combine like terms. So this right here gives me 4x, like that. And then this looks like a negative 2, I guess. All right. Now, there's a name for this equation. Does anybody know the name of it? Say it again.
Two-step equation.
Good. So how do I solve that thing? Add 2 and then what? Divide by 4. Real simple. So if I add 2, I get my stupid number, 132, which I don't want. And then if I divide by 4, I'm going to use my calculator. How much?
33.
33, thank you. So we're done, 33. X is equal to 33. Bless you. Now, if they want to know more than X, like in other words, if they want to know that angle, how would I find that angle? So I would do 3 times 33, very good, plus what? Plus 2. Excellent. That's all we're doing today. Now, I don't know that I missed anything, but it's possible. I need you to try 5.2. I didn't give you any homework last night because I figured really the distance formula is all I needed you to know. We don't have a lot of time, 20 minutes, but try to start working on these. So go to 483.